words of my mouth and the meditation of our hearts be always pleasing in your sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. We started by singing that song, and I don't know about you, but I can remember singing that in junior school. I went to a state school, but things were a bit different back then, and at the end of every assembly we did prayers and we sang songs and those sorts of things, and they were Christian songs. By this everyone will know that you are my disciples, if you love one another. It seems like a perhaps trite thing to say, almost, you know. You hear people who say things like, well, aren't all religions just about loving people? No, is the short answer. They're not. Sadly, often in its history, Christianity hasn't been about loving others. You know, if you even take a glance through it, sometimes we've done a very good job. Sometimes we just like to skip over the other bits of history. But we shouldn't, because we miss out on the truth, don't we? And there is, in this night, two very significant acts of love that are worth our time meditating on, praying on, thinking about. The first is the act of washing the feet. And that is a profound act of love. In those days, and I've mentioned this before, to wash someone's feet was either an acknowledgement that they were significantly more powerful than you, a sign of great respect for your teacher, you would wash their feet, or the act of someone out of love for someone else. So picture a mother washing a small child, as opposed to a dad who'd probably just get out the hose and just hose them down. I don't know. So I've spoken about that before, and it's, you know, but the thing to recognize there is that this is not just an instruction that applies to in the church. It applies to all. You know, you don't just love people who are like you. God's love extends further than those boundaries. But the second act of love is one that we often return to but perhaps don't recognize. The central gathering exercise for many of us Christians is that we gather and we break bread, and we share it, we take wine, and we bless it, and we share it. And this, we understand this as somehow, by God's grace, connecting us to Christians all around the world and throughout time. We're a part of something. I was at a funeral a little while ago, and there's some wonderful, miraculous transformation that happens in funerals. But not all. But that's the coming together of people who have lost something, and in that loss find a common ground. You may have your own experiences of that. And it's something we often try and protect children from, loss. But if you never lose, you never learn, you never grow. It is, I'm told, very damaging for children to never lose anything. You don't want them to lose too much, that's pretty damaging too. As parents, we try and get it right and ask for forgiveness when we get it wrong. In this meal that we share, the bread and the wine, we come together and we share a common loss. That's the loss that the disciples were just about to experience. The loss of literally having Jesus walk alongside them and being able to see him and ask him questions and that they would be able to hopefully understand the answers. Not always. And this is a loss we keep experiencing in different ways. There are many questions I would love to sit down with Jesus and ask. I'm sure you have your own. And we don't have that. And so we have a gap. And it's in that gap that we come together. But it's also in that gap that we find common ground where we might reach out in love to people who are also hurting and missing something. Thanks to that, and I do mean thanks to that, we also have other gifts. We have the Holy Spirit who's with us, and when we meet together, God is with us in the Holy Spirit, and we pray that the Holy Spirit will guide us into wisdom and truth. Small steps. But it's in the loss. It's in the brokenness. It's in the fractured nature of our lives that we experience our own brokenness. So like the bread, we might be broken and shared, but we also experience wholeness in that same moment. And we do so because we find love. We find the love that God has for us and the love that God calls us to share with those who gather with us around the table and then allow it to overflow into the world, which is much in need of God's love and presence. In the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.